At the Impact Arena, Pacio in the blue corner with the red shorts. Amnuaysirichoke, red tape and the black shorts. So much on the line, and possibly, Mitch, a shot at the title with a convincing performance from one of these two tonight. One championship, all on the line here tonight. Another epic episode of Thailand versus the Philippines.
That's right, Chris. Both these fighters feel they deserve another shot at the belt. And one minor mistake was all it took to cost them the strap. And now is their shot to get it back into the title hunt.
Pacio going with the high point kick. Amnuaysirichoke stalking forward. Pacio moving backwards. Sirichoke with a switch kick, blocked by Pacio.
Typically we see Crew Wrong, which is Amnuaysirichoke's nickname. We see him start a little bit slower, but he's actually really trying to put the pressure on Pacio, and he's starting a lot faster than he usually does.
And as we see him close down the distance, it would seem to be to the avoidance of the movement skills and speed of Pacio. Big kick again there from Amnuaysirichoke. Pacio presses the clinch.
When you fought Muay Thai over 350 times at the absolute highest level, you have a skill set on your feet that is incomparable to anybody out there. You gotta wonder when Pacio is gonna try to take this to the ground, because you can see him try an outside trip there, but Dej has got just such a strong base, and he just really stops. He's really so strong in the clinch, but he's gotta try to swim underneath Pacio. Ah. Pacio was able to get the double underhooks, use that to get this fight to the ground.
Pacio using those deep underhooks, as Mitch explained there, to destabilize Amnuaysirichoke. And here with plenty of time on the clock, Mitch, Pacio probably where he wanted this one from the beginning.
Yeah, that's exactly where he wants to be. He wants to be on top, have Amnuaysirichoke on the bottom, and just tire him out. Utilize those body shots like he's doing right now to slowly start to watch Amnuaysirichoke fade. But it's just not gonna happen. And it's only a three-round fight. We didn't see Amnuaysirichoke start to fade until like that fourth and fifth round when he fought Naito, because he's got the juice to go all three rounds pretty heavily.
And Amnuaysirichoke doing the right thing here to try to pull Pacio down, break his posture, and hand fight a bit, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing that. He's definitely trying to stop the ground and pound, but he's keeping his guard closed, which just traps Pacio in that ground and pound position. So he's just kind of holding him there to drop these bombs. He's got to let go of the feet and start to scramble and maybe get back up to his feet.
Referee watching very carefully here, and somebody right now, Mitch, needs to work to improve this position, but it's Amnuaysirichoke going here to grab the neck.
He's got a guillotine, and the crowd is definitely responding to this packed arena here at Impact Stadium, but I think he's a bit too high. He's only got one hand on it, so he's really just holding the head of Pacio. Pacio's gonna pop his head out like he just did, and really just see how he's just softening up the body, but I like how Amnuaysirichoke's throwing elbows from the bottom.
And the name of the game here would be to perhaps force a stand-up.
Ooh, that's what he needed to do. He opened his guard, shrimped out to the side, and started moving away, but Pacio immediately jumped over that and ended up in a half guard. But we see Pacio, he's really not trying to pass the guard of Amnuaysirichoke. He's just able to sit there, and he's content just to beat him up, which is that ground and pound that we spoke about at the beginning of the fight.
Right now, Pacio capitalizing on a momentary lapse of concentration from Amnuaysirichoke, sitting here in half. Olivia Coast calling for both fighters to work here, but I feel like the onus is on Pacio right now.
Yeah, definitely. He's definitely scoring a lot of the ground and pound, and he's controlling the top position. Most people believe if you're on top, you're winning the fight, unless you're doing a lot of damage or you're really throwing up a lot of submissions, which Amnuaysirichoke is not doing right now. He's just kind of holding on to that half guard, and he's also holding on to the body, which is draining. It's going to take a lot of energy to hold on to somebody as strong as Pacquiao is and try not to let him go.
And he's certainly trying to protect himself and use that lockdown. As you'll see, he's got the ankle underneath his calf, and of course the other ankle grapevined in, Mitch. He's doing the right thing, but the big question is it enough?
Yeah, he's got the black belt Progenio Issa in his corner right now, shouting out instructions through the translator in the corner there. So Amnuaysirichoke has the best vantage point possible, but Pacio was just too much on top. The ground and pound coming from Pacio. Looks like he might have a neck here and a guillotine.
Pacio looking to finish here, holding on to the neck. Just a few seconds left in the round. And the fans cheering for Amnuaysirichoke, who has certainly had to weather an early storm as Pacio ends the round on top. Would you just listen to the fans in here, Mitch?
Yeah, we saw the ground and pound from Pacio. We saw the Muay Thai from Amnuaysirichoke, and every fight's gonna start onto his feet. Look at this beautiful head movement there to counter with a kick of his own. But then this is where the story of the fight really started to happen. The top control of Pacio, where he was just able to control, soften him up. It'll be interesting to hear Rich Franklin's opinion on what he thought of that first round.
Well, I'll tell you, when the round first started, I had Dej actually come out and score a little bit on the stand-up with the striking superiority, but that was overshadowed by the ground control that Pacio had there. And although this is showing the ground control, I had Pacio scoring in the damage category as well. A lot of superficial damage because you see the cut that they're working on Dej's face there. But you can see when Dej was walking away at the end of the round, you can see the hematomas on the right side of his head too. So that damage actually starting to add up. So Pacio's beginning to score in the higher categories. At this point in time, I have him ahead on the scorecards.
Well, it's been a workmanship performance thus far from Pacio. And when we saw plenty of striking from the outset, Mitch, it became really a grappling affair for most of that round.
And that it did, but we didn't really see a lot of grappling. We saw just the control of Pacio on top. Once he was able to get on top, he didn't choose to pass. He wasn't trying to advance his position. He was content just to sit there on top and beat Amnuaysirichoke.
Well, the second of a scheduled 3, 5 minutes on the clock here, and it starts on the feet, just like in the previous round. Let's see what happens between two men who we know can strike.
Pacio's threatening that side kick again. Look how fast that kick comes out. No setup whatsoever. He just throws it out there.
Amnuaysirichoke with the punishing counter. And Pacio certainly taking a very quick route on those kicks. Not as much power, Mitch, but certainly quick kicks.
Big leg kick by Amnuaysirichoke. This is where he needs to keep the fight. He needs to keep his distance, but he's consistently moving forward. If Pacio, yep, caught a kick, picks him up, sends him down with a huge takedown to end up in side control, which is not a good spot for Amnuaysirichoke.
A single kick from Amnuaysirichoke and the penalty, an opportunity for Pacio to take him down and straight into side control. Mitch, that's efficient.
Yeah, I would have thought the corner would have been like, all right, ease up on the leg kicks, let's throw some hands, let's keep this fight on the feet, start moving around. But Pacio caught that leg kick, and now we're back in the same position that we ended the first round in, and there's a lot of time for Pacio to start working.
Pacio working the wrestling department here again in half and utilizing the odd ground and pound to try to open up position and possibly a pass.
Yeah, this is a good position for Pacio. He's really able to do a lot of damage. We've got 3.5 minutes left, and this is where Pacio is gonna be able to do most of his handiwork. He's just on top, dropping that ground and pound, and that's really been the story of the fight so far in what we're approaching is the first half of the fight.
He's going to work on that far side arm. Tough to see from our angle here on the monitor. There we go, much better. Possible straight arm bar here.
Yeah, he's got the straight arm bar, but he might transition into a Kimura where Amnuaysirichoke seems to be keeping the arm straight. It's going to be very hard to submit at that position. Amnuaysirichoke just shook it off. He's got to create more scrambles. He's like trying to maybe conserve his energy. But Pacio is really strong on top, so I could be wrong in saying that he's not trying to create scrambles. But Pacio is just controlling and grounding and pounding.
One thing interesting of note here is that Pacio, there we go, that was what I was looking for, was an attempt to try to actively pass and not just use the ground and pound to try to open up a pass. Pressing on the knee, Pacio now trying to force his way into mount, but great defense there from Amnuaysirichoke.
Yeah, he's defending, he's keeping it in half guard, but he's worrying more about the pass, so he's enabling Pacio to drop even more shots into him. And he's controlling, he's got a cradle position. This is Amnuaysirichoke shot to get back up to his feet.
Oh, Amnuaysirichoke trying to explode. Pacio thinking about the back take here and goes with the body lock.
Amnuaysirichoke gave up his back in the attempt to get back up to his feet. He might get suplexed here, but Pacio transitions to a single leg. Beautiful takedown by Pacio.
Great defense there from Amnuaysirichoke again, but Pacio one step ahead. Gets him down again to the canvas here. Let's see what he can do with it.
I think it's gonna be more of the same, Chris. I think he's just comfortable to sit in the half guard and start dropping bombs, because I don't think he might try to pass. It looks like he's trying to work the knee up towards the hips of Amnuaysirichoke to maybe pop that knee out through the legs. But it's just, this is where he does his best work. He likes to control the opponents and really just beat him up from the top.
And certainly when you consider the striking skills of Amnuaysirichoke, despite Pacio being proficient in that department, this is probably the path of least resistance.
Yeah, there's very few people in the world that can stand up with him. And actually, there might be a few of them here in the stadium tonight, but because we are in Thailand. But primarily, this is where Pacio wants to keep this fight. He wants to keep it on the ground, keep Amnuaysirichoke back flat against the mat here. And just now he's attempting the Kimura again. It looks like he's trying to attack the far side arm, but Amnuaysirichoke's doing the right thing by keeping his elbows nice and tight, but the crowd is really getting into this little bit of a ground and pound exchange by these two.
And even as Amnuaysirichoke throws short punches and elbows off his back, the crowd cheering every time they land, but Pacio staying busy just enough to keep this one down on the ground.
And that's exactly his game plan. You can hear Mark Sangrillo yelling at him what he wants him to do, and that's gotta be just keep him down, beat him up on the mat, and eventually, when this round ends in about 20 seconds, 10 seconds, they're gonna get another shot on the feet. And you gotta wonder, is Dej's corner gonna be like, all right, no more leg kicks, let's use just the hands and see if we can change the possible destiny of this contest here tonight.
The crowd at fever pitch here in the Impact Arena as we see the second round come to a close. A flurry from both men. It started on the feet. Talk us through the action, Mitch.
Yeah, here's the leg kick. He threw the leg. Boom. Pacio was able to transition right into a big takedown. And here's that attempted Kimura or a straight arm bar that Dejdamrong was able to run off. But then this was the story of the fight. Pacio able to get on top, control where the fight's happening, and just beat up Dej from the top. Rich, what do you got?
I'll tell you, Pacio just increased his lead on the ground control there. And I might go so far as to say that Dej may actually need to knock him out in order to win this fight. Pacio's had too much time on the ground as far as control, and he's also scoring in the damage category, which is a higher category. You saw the armbar there on the replay. I did not score him a near sub. It just wasn't close enough to actually make any score there, but I have some notation on my score sheet. But at this point in time, he's increased his lead so much that, like I said, in order for Dej to win this, okay, he may actually need to get a finish here.
And we will put 5 minutes on the clock, the final round of this contest, and possibly, as you heard it from Rich Franklin, as well as Mitch Chilson alongside me here tonight at the Impact Arena, that amount of time left for Amnuaysirichoke to finish this contest if he wants a win.
He's got, see, he immediately keeps going. He goes right after the punches, and that needs to be where he needs to go. He needs to throw the hands, stay away from the takedown, be careful with his kicks, because Pacio is snatching those kicks up very quickly, and he's able to transition into some big takedowns.
And you're seeing, again, a lot of pressure here from Amnuaysirichoke. Constant forward movement. On the back foot is Pacio. Left hand followed by Amnuaysirichoke, and then Pacio thinking about the takedown, shrugged off. That's better from Amnuaysirichoke.
Yeah, that's what he wants. He wants to be able to stop the takedown, but I like how he's not throwing any kicks. He's going just after the hands. Nice uppercut there from Pacio, though.
Overextension from Amnuaysirichoke. Uppercut counter there from Pacio. Man, these are some exchanges, Mitch.
He stopped the takedown, and now we got ourselves a boxing match. So let's see what kind of gas that Pacio has as he shoots in for the takedown. Dej is able to stop it. Very good.
Third time again, shut down by Amnuaysirichoke. Pacio now for the first time, possibly on the back foot more often than not. Surging in confidence is Amnuaysirichoke. Wow, what an incredible opportunity here for Pacio. Can you get him down?
Oh, that was a good shot. He faked the takedown, went right back after it again. Just that constant chain wrestling, going for takedown after takedown. Amnuaysirichoke sprawling heavy, able to stop his third takedown of this round. He's got to turn it on. He's got 3 minutes for the knockout, as Rich Franklin says, might be his only way to win this fight.
Well, the reshot there from Pacio was impressive indeed, but Dej in stalking mode, man, as he goes off the left hand, the crowd really hanging on the edge of their seat here at the Impact Arena. As the title connects again with the right hand, Pacio in desperation mode, thinking about the double leg, Mitch.
He's got him up against the cage. This might be a chance for him to gather his wits, because it looked like Dejdamrong connected with some big shots there.
Pacio trying to get those hands together. Amnuaysirichoke able to keep his hips away and continues to pour on the pressure. The clock is running over the midway point of this round.
Pacio looks to be fading a little bit. He looks a little bit tired. His mouth is open as Dej starts to pour it on with a body shot. Goes to the body, goes to the head. Oh, with a big right hand.
Body head from Amnuaysirichoke as he continues to waltz forward and pour on the multiple punch combinations. Pacio looks tired, Mitch.
They're giving the crowd exactly what they want. The Philippine versus Thailand striking battle.
And Amnuaysirichoke continues to plod onwards. Out comes the mouthpiece from Pacio. Pacio looks rocked.
But look at the chin of Pacio. He's hanging in there with a Lupini, a three-time Lupini world champion. Shoots it for the takedown. Dej shuts it off, gets his back.
Amnuaysirichoke looking for the back take. The right hand punches coming in, and he's got the seatbelt, Mitch.
He's got the back. Pacio trying to stand up as Dej starts to hammer. It's important to know we are judging the fight on its entirety, not round by round. Big head kick.
Oh, man, what a connection again from the Thai fighter. So much aggression and certainly plenty of accuracy from Amnuaysirichoke.
I like the uppercut that Pacio's throwing because it's landing, but Dej is stalking after the Filipino, throwing heavy hands. They trade push kicks and continue to battle. Finally, Olivier Cost gives Pacio his mouthpiece back.
What a fight. What a fight tonight. And the crowd absolutely in so much support for Amnuaysirichoke. Pacio struggling to put things together. Can he turn it around, Mitch?
This is very close. He's doing a lot of good, but Pacio is really hanging in there. He looks a little bit tired, but he's still answering right back, and he's also landing strikes. Dej just is moving forward, and he's got the crowd on his side, but Pacio is right in there still.
And it's a sprint to the finish line as Amnuaysirichoke rips to the legs with the kicks. Pacio looking for something here. Amnuaysirichoke, a swing and a miss. 10-second clapper's gone.
Pacio is doing good. He's standing there. He got caught with a leg kick. I would like to see him catch it, going for the takedown. That could have been the punctuation mark he needed. But a body kick to end the round. What a fight, Chris.
What a performance from Amnuaysirichoke in the third round. But Pacio was oh so impressive to take the Thai fighter out of his game. Mitch, that was full fat action for 5 minutes.
This was a very impressive part of the story for me. Hear how he's able to push the head down, stop three takedown attempts very effectively to keep this fight on the feet. He stopped with the kicks, went after the hands, and there's a big right hand from Pacio. Rich Franklin, what do you got for him?
I'll tell you what, look, both of these guys were aggressive. I gave Dej the aggression category. Obviously, Pacio won the takedown category. Dej was still able to defend some takedowns. Ground control Pacio the whole fight. But there was no ground in the third round there. In the third round, Dej actually ran away with the striking superiority. I think he actually mounted more damage, but the time of control on the ground was in Pacio's favor, and I would give him the decision here.
Wow, Amnuaysirichoke came back with everything he had, showed a lot of fight IQ in the third there, but a lot of domination on display from Pacio, who will take that one step closer to title contention here tonight for the packed out crowd at the Impact Arena at One Championship Warrior Kingdom. So much there. The first time we go the distance tonight, and we will hear from Dominic Lau to make the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout for the blue corner. Judge number two scores this bout for the red corner. And judge number three scores this bout for your winner by way of split decision from the blue corner, Joshua Pacio.
We go the distance tonight in one championship, but it's a win for Pacio in the end after a thrilling three rounds. A vintage performance from both men. What an incredible night so far. More coming up next in one championship.